Hey guys, welcome to the first video of this new channel called Ork Slayer Gamedev. My name is Adrian, or as we pronounce it here, Adrian. As you can guess, I am the developer of the game Ork Slayer. I wanna talk about a few things in this short video, then I will make future content based on your reactions. Hopefully, I can reach out to an audience that is potentially interested in my work. So, what is Ork Slayer? Ork Slayer is an under-development turn-based RPG pixel art game made only with PYGAME. The story is under construction, although I have a lot of ideas for the game. Strictly speaking, I would call this a solo project, but I had the help of my best friend, so I'd rather mention this game as a 1.5-man project. Where does this idea come from? I'm planning to make an individual video about this topic in the future, so if you're interested, be sure to stay tuned for that. Anyways, I made my physics thesis about a project in Python, and by the time I had no knowledge in coding, so I took the opportunity and started making the original Ork Slayer. That was an ASCII game that didn't require a graphical window. As for my recent thesis work, I started working with GUIs, and that was the reason I started using the module called PyGame. So the original game is somewhere around 2 years old, and I've been working on this new one since last year's fall, so a couple of months now. What are the features of the game? I wanted to keep the guideline of my original game, but with additional elements. ASCII is now completely replaced with pixel art, and I have more room to implement stuff. Note that I'm not a professional programmer nor a professional artist, I just make this for my own entertainment and challenge, and I thought it's time to bring this project one step up and show it to a possible audience here on YouTube. Another important thing is that everything you see in this game is made by myself alone. There are features needed for every game and more specific ones. I will list some of them right now. Menu system with different GUIs. The game can be controlled using the keyboard to navigate inside the menus. Selectable heroes. Right now, the hero system works a bit different. You can customize yourself as for the race, class and gender. Unfortunately, I feel that this rather would be similar to an MMORPG, so I want to replace this feature. I really want to give the characters personality, there will be 4 of them, I will talk about this in another video. Interesting story. I can't tell much about the story now, but I promise it will be well made. It's in progress right now, but I want to make something similar like I was doing in the first game. Turn-based battles. There can be up to 3 enemies, but the hero fights alone, for now. This is still an open question. Also, I want to replace turn-based fight to time-based fight. I always loved these kinds of games, and I really wanna try this feature, I see potential in it. Loot, including golden potions. There's a potion inventory that is accessible within the fight as well, so the heroes can heal themselves up. After each fight, the hero can grab some loot as the reward of success. Leveling system. The heroes can level up with the fights. This opens up ways to upgrade attributes and stats, as well to unlock new skills that can turn the favors of the battles. Equipment. There's an equipment inventory between fights where the players can see their weapons and armors. Dialogue screens. I wanted to make dialogue screens so the NPCs and the heroes all will have personalities, they will be unique, and the game will be a bit more immersive. 4 different merchants. The set equipment is also upgradable. There's a tier list that I will explain in a future video, but it's based on my RPG experiences. Different biomes and enemies. There's only one biome now and a couple of enemies, but there's a lot of ideas in my head, they just need to be implemented. Pixel art. Last but not least, the game's graphics is pixel art, since I love this style and I love drawing things pixel by pixel. There are all kinds of animations like character movement and shining items, but I want to widen the scope and make the game more immersive and eye-catching. What is the definitive goal for the game? For now, I just want to experience. I want to see how many people can I involve in this community and see if you guys like it or not. If I get a lot of good feedback, I will definitely continue coming up with more content and future videos. As for funding, the game is now being produced on a zero budget. I take occasional jobs besides the development. I will keep up the work until I can make it with these circumstances, and I hope for the best. That was it for now. If you watched the video until the end, thank you so much. If you like what I'm doing, please contribute with a humble like. Also, you can tell me your opinion or ideas in the comment section. And if you don't want to miss out any future content, you can also subscribe. It would be much appreciated. And again, thank you guys. I hope to see you around. Take care.